Is this question solvable? My friend, I have been arguing over this equation and I'm curious if it's possible. Our teacher gave us the answer as follows. I think this is incorrect because no calculator can give me this answer and I found two calculators that give equal solutions, which is this right here. Alright, let's go over this. First, this is the function that we're trying to differentiate and this is the answer that your teacher gave you and I'll tell you right away, this right here is incorrect because you see, we have the 4x minus 2. We can factor out a 2 right here. Well, yeah, you're supposed to do that, but no, just kidding. That's not the main issue here. The main issue is the calculus, it's not just the algebra, right? And let me show you what I think happened it, and the following is just incorrect, right? So let's go over this. So it looks like we are trying to differentiate this function, 9x to the 4x minus 2, and then raised to the third power. So we have this thing to the third power, so let's just go ahead and bring the power to the front, and then we end up with 3, and then we have this, which is 9x to the 4x minus 2. And then we have to use the chain rule, good. So we are just going to look at the inside right here. 9 is just a constant multiple, so I'm just going to multiply by 9. And then the derivative of x to the 4x minus 2 is what? Well, it seems like what happened was this. This right here is a power situation. We have this to a power. So I think what happened is just that, you know, bring that to the front and minus 1. So you have that factor, 4x minus 2 in the front here. And then x raised to the 4x minus 3, right? So that's how we have this portion. And then lastly, what's the derivative of 4x minus 2? It's just a 4, so multiply by 4. So that's the last chain rule part. And if you multiply the numbers, here we have the 3 times 9, which is 27, times 4, which is 108. So we have the 108 right here. And then we have this part, which is 4x minus 2. And then we have this part right here, which is x to the 4x minus 3. And lastly, we have this part right here, which is 9x to the 4x minus 2. All right, so there are several mistakes in this regard. Firstly, I agree that you can look at this to the third power and then use the power rule. Bring the 3 to the front, but you see right here, there was no 2 right here. You're supposed to minus 2, so that should have been a 2. But again, that's not the major issue. Okay, you keep that right here, right? 9. The major issue is this right here. This is the main calculus part, right? Because here is x. It's a function for the base. And then the power here, it's also a function because we have the x. So we cannot do this power rule like this anymore. If it's a number, then yes, you can bring the number to the front and then minus 1, and then you get that 2 right here. But if the power is also a function, no, this right here is incorrect. Right? This right here is incorrect. So let's see how we can actually cross all this out. Right? So make sure you just cross this out. And let's see how we can get this right. Firstly, let's go ahead and simplify this. Right here we have a multiplication, so we can just distribute the power. This will be 9 to the third power times x, and then multiply the powers here. So 3 times 4x minus 2. All right, work this out. 9 to the third power, we get 729x, and then distribute the 3, we get 12x minus 6. So our f of x is that, and be careful, because x is in the base, and we also have x in the power, so do not bring the power to the front and minus 1 for the derivative. No. So what do we do though? Well, the problem here is that we have x for the base, and we don't like that. What do we like? Well, we like to have that, e. So how can we make that happen? Let me show you. The key right here is that we will rewrite this x as e to the ln x power. Because we really want to have e for the base, and of course e and ln cancel, so we are purposely writing this for the x, okay? And then, of course, let's just put on rest. We have 729. This is for our x right here, and then we still have that 12x minus 6. And once we have this, we can go ahead and multiply the powers again. So this right here is 729 times e for the base. And then this right here is 12x minus 6, and then multiply by ln x. So our f of x is this. Now let's go ahead and take a look at this expression and take the derivative for that. F prime of x equals, right here we have a constant multiple, 729. So let's go ahead and just put that down right away. Then when we take the derivative of e to the whatever, this thing right here just repeats. So let's go ahead and just write that down. E to the 12x minus 6 times ln x. Then we will have to use the chain rule. So look at this right here and take the derivative. Well, right here, this is a product of two functions, so we will have to use the product rule as well. Let's go ahead and keep the first function, which is 12x minus 6, and then times the derivative of the second. The derivative of ln x is 1 over x. And then we are going to add the second function, which is ln x times the derivative of the first. The derivative of this is just 12. So that's pretty much it. Now the rest is just the simplification. Have a look. Here we still have that 729. And what's this part though? E to this thing is this right here. And if you trace back, it's this, which is just x to the 12x minus 6, right? So it's just that function part without the 729. So it's that, okay? So let's go ahead and just write that down right here. X to the 12x minus 6. And then for this right here, let's see, perhaps we can get the common denominator because we have the x right here. So let's go ahead and multiply this by x and this by x. So we will have all over x, and then this is 12x minus 6. This is 12x times ln x. So let's go ahead and put that down first. 12x times ln x, like so. So notice here we have 12, and then 6, and then 12, so we can factor out a 6. So this right here is 729 times x to the 12x minus 6 times the 6 that we are factoring out. And let's also put the over x right here. So we have 6 over x. And then the inside will be 12x divided by 6 is 2x, and then minus 6 divided by 6 is minus 1, and then 12, right, and 6 is plus 2x ln x. And lastly, we see that here, 729 times 6, we get 4,354. And then right here, this and that, they both have x for the base, so we can just subtract the powers. 12x minus 6, and then this is x to the first power. So we will just get x to the 12x minus 7, right? This minus that. And then the rest is 2x minus 1 plus 2x times ln x. Whew. And this right here is the derivative, which that's the answer that you got on your calculator as well. So hopefully this right here helps. That's it.